edition of Cooking Inside Out. Today I'm starting a new project I'm calling the Wok Project. This project is going to look at stir fries, particularly stir fries with a Chinese influence. Some of them will be fairly authentic, as I understand it from having read about Chinese dishes, and some of them will be things we find on lots of Chinese American restaurant menus that aren't necessarily authentic. And today's one of those, Mongolian beef. Mongolian beef, as I understand it, is not a true Chinese dish, but you'll find it in many Chinese restaurants. And the version we're going to make certainly uses a lot of Chinese flavors. So with that, we're going to have installment one of the Wok Project, Mongolian beef. Start out by preparing our beef. You'll find many different beefs used in stir-fried recipes. Flank steak is very common. I've seen them using round steak, top round steak. The recipe that inspired this one is one from a blog called tigersandstrawberries.com, written by a lady named Barbara Fisher. Has recipes for all sorts of different kinds of cooking, but particularly a lot of Chinese cooking and a lot of techniques. I would encourage you to go to her website. Again, it's www.tigersandstrawberries. Let me try that again. www.tigersandstrawberries.com. Look at her recipes and particularly her techniques on stir frying. The recipe that I said this is inspired by, it's not exactly her recipe, but in her recipe she uses beef tenderloin cut into medallions. We're actually today going to use a piece of top sirloin, mainly for budgetary reasons. But with any stir-fried meat, you want to cut it across the grain. The grain in this piece of meat runs this way. And you want to cut it into thin strips with a little bit of bias, usually. Get rid of that first piece. So we're just going to slice our beef up here into nice thin strips cut across the grain of the beef. And now that we have our beef sliced up, we're going to give it a little marinade. So we're going to take our beef. We're going to add a tablespoon of dark soy sauce and a tablespoon of light soy sauce. You can find these in your Asian markets. There's several different brands of them. I really like the Pearl River Bridge brand. They are different than what you'll find in most supermarkets. So it pays you to seek out the soy sauces. The dark soy sauce is darker and heavier. It has a little bit of molasses added to it, in addition to being brewed a little darker. So we're going to stir that together, and then we're going to add a tablespoon of cornstarch. And again, stir it all together. And yes, I'm making a bit of a mess, but that's part of the fun of cooking. And your hands are definitely the best tool to do this with. I've seen people do it with chopsticks, spoons, but your hands are some of the best tools for this. So now that we've got our beef sitting here, we're going to let it marinate for at least 20 minutes. And while we do that, we can prep up the vegetables. Our beef's been marinated for about 20 minutes now. And we have our other ingredients prepared to go into our Mongolian beef stir fry. What I have here is one medium onion that's been cut in half and then sliced very thin, as you can see. Two cloves of garlic peeled and thinly sliced. About a tablespoon and a half or so of thinly sliced ginger, a couple of jalapenos, and then we have our sauce that we're going to use in our stir fry. What's in this sauce is a tablespoon of hoisin sauce. You can find hoisin sauces either in your Asian market or in most supermarkets. Oyster sauce. Again, you can find oyster sauce in most of your supermarkets as well as Asian markets. But if you really want a nice premium one, go to the Asian markets and look for one that has oysters as the first ingredient. If you look at a lot of the ones you'll find in your supermarket, oyster or oyster extract is well down the ingredients. Ground bean sauce or bean sauce, and this you can find in Asian markets. Ground bean sauce and bean sauce are basically the same, except that the bean sauce will have a few pieces of the fermented black beans in it, whereas the ground bean sauce has been ground up to be smooth. Chili garlic sauce, cheng kang, or chin kang, if you're Chinese, pardon my pronunciation, vinegar. It's a Chinese black vinegar. You can find this again in Asian markets. A lot of people, or a lot of recipes call for substituting balsamic if you can't find it. I guess they're similar in flavor. I've not tried balsamic in a stir fry like this. And I think there's a fair amount of difference in the taste, but I see a lot of recipes that say use balsamic. So if you can't find the black vinegar, give that a try. And again, I think I skipped the quantities on this, so it's a tablespoon of hoisin, two tablespoons of oyster, a tablespoon and a half of the bean sauce, a teaspoon of the chili garlic sauce, you can add more if you want it hotter, a a teaspoon of the rice vinegar, and then I also have in there 2 teaspoons of dry sherry. Again, you'll see lots of recipes calling for Shaoxing wine. I can't find that other than the cooking version, but dry sherry supposedly substitutes really well, and I've read that in several recipes, so I use the dry sherry, and a couple of teaspoons of sugar, and that all goes into our sauce. And so now we have our ingredients ready, and we're going to start stir frying.